plaintiff, Jeremy Sokol, has a 14-year-old daughter with the defendant. But the defendant hasn't seen their child in 5 years because she's a heroin addict. Jeremy claims he got custody of his daughter when she was 6 years old because of the defendant's drug addiction. And he's suing her today for child support. Defendant Michelle Firm admits that she's made a lot of mistakes in her life, but she insists she was a good mother. Michelle claims she only became addicted to heroin after a crooked doctor overprescribed her pain medication. Michelle insists the only reason she hasn't seen her daughter is because Jeremy won't allow it.
Start with you.
Your Honor, I haven't even seen this woman in 5 years. We have a child together. My child hasn't seen her in five years.
How old is the child?
My daughter is 14. She'll be 15 next month. Either one of us have seen her in 5 years.
What is that about?
Your Honor, she's a heroin addict. I mean, this woman has been addicted to heroin for 8 years. She's been in and out of correctional facilities off and on since 2007.
How about rehab? You say correctional facilities. How about rehab facilities?
Well, I don't...
To your knowledge.
I don't know of any rehab facilities that she has been, you know, going through successfully or otherwise. But, Your Honor, you know, my daughter had came to live with me when she was 6 years old. After I had done some investigating, it had been brought to my attention by someone that's deeply involved in that subculture of junkies, you know, that they say, hey, you know, your kid's mother is on that scene, Jeremy. So I went and I talked to my child's school. She had missed over 50 days of kindergarten. I had spoken to her pediatrician. There were issues there. And as of December 2007, the woman was convicted of possession of heroin in West Virginia.
That's not true.
At the time, I was given custody the next month, January of 2008. I was given emergency temporary custody. I have the court order that the...
Let's see it, please.
Sure. Thank you. I was given emergency temporary custody January 18th of 2008, and then I was granted full custody April the 1st, 2008.
Okay, let me allow her to give some background so we can get to that first contradiction I heard. Ma'am?
Your Honor, I admit that I've made a lot of mistakes in my life, but being a good mother wasn't one of them. My kids were well taken care of. In 2003, I was in a car accident. Then I started seeing a doctor. He put me on pain medication. I was getting 120 Oxycontin a month, 90 Percocets a month, 90 Xanax a month. I went to that guy.
Yet you were a good mother.
Well.
You had nerve enough to say that in here? You were a good mother while you were a dope fiend? I don't know whether you are or not now, but you're admitting that you were a dope fiend and the first thing out your mouth was I was a good mother? Wow. Go ahead. What else you want me to know? What else you want me to know?
I took very good care of my children.
I heard that, ma'am. I heard that. And I promise you, nobody in America believes that.
And I would have never went to... I got cut off from my doctor. He got in trouble for being a crooked doctor. Yeah, well, I mean, it might seem funny, except for, you know, people, this happens all the time. People end up trying to raise...
I'm a little compassionate about that when it starts out with an injury, but yeah, you lose that compassion with me when you come here thinking that you took care of your children fine and great they lived a great life while you were a dope fiend. That's when the compassion ends and the compassion begins with those children. Go ahead, ma'am.
Okay, Your Honor. I did get an accident in 2003.
Got that part. Tell me about this lie that he told or you told. He said you were convicted in 07 of possession of drugs, and as a result, 1 month later, the child was removed from you for emergency custody. What happened?
Sir, I was in West Virginia. I got pulled over. I was actually a passenger in a car, and they found a spoon in the car, and since it was on my side of the car, they said that it was mine and charged me with possession.
How long ago was that?
Not of heroin. That was in 2007.
Okay. So you were still a dope fiend then, right?
Yes, sir.
All right. So you lied. Now, I got that part. And so I don't know how many rehabs you've been to, but it's not working for you to come in here and lie just that quickly about not having drugs and that leading to the removal of your child. So have you been to rehab?
Yes, Your Honor.
How many times?
Twice.
Why only twice?
Because, can I explain myself?
No, I want you to answer these questions.
Well, just this last time, I actually wanted to get help because when he did come and get custody of my kid.
So the other times you didn't want to get help?
The other times I really didn't even care.
Okay.
Because he took my reason for living away.
I got that part, ma'am. You didn't care. That's why you didn't go. I know people who go 5, 6, 7 times within the 8-year period trying because they do care and because they have children. But go ahead. What else you want me to know?
Okay. Well, let me just say, for the first 7 years of her life, he didn't have anything to do with her. He would come in. He wasn't there for her birth. He didn't want her to have his last name. She was 3 months old, and then he decided he wanted a paternity test.
Your Honor.
Let her say her piece, sir.
Okay.
This doesn't excuse anything she did.
Well,
Go ahead.
There's a lot of lies being told, and when you do that, you take straw out of the baby Jesus' manger, and I'm real worried he's going to be cold this Christmas because the untruths coming off of that side of the room right now are astronomical. Now, I didn't even know I had a child until she was 2 years old, because this woman let another man believe that it was his child. Her and I had a very brief affair in September of 2000, at which time we ended it when I found out she had a boyfriend she had been living with for 2 years. Your Honor, I had moved city of Columbus.
You knew I had a boyfriend.
After. Well, I knew you had, I'd found out you had a boyfriend, and then we stopped talking.
He knew the whole time.
Regardless, I moved on.
Did you tell him it was another man's child, ever?
I told him, I was with a different man when
seeing
him.
I just asked you a very simple question.
I told him that it
question.
Could be between That's, him and
All right,
and
so there it is,
Mr.
All right.
I haven't even seen this woman in 5 years. We have a child together, my child hasn't seen her in 5 years.
What is that about?
Well, Your Honor, she's a heroin addict.
Defendant Michelle Firm has a 14-year-old daughter with the plaintiff. But the plaintiff claims Michelle hasn't seen the child in 5 years because she's a heroin addict.
So let's get back to the child support.
Your Honor,
sir.
When paternity was established, I did my part. I never missed a payment. I did extras. The car that this woman wrecked was a vehicle that I gave to her to make sure that my child had transportation to school.
How long have
to
you
a hospital.
Had custody? That's
I got custody of my daughter in January of 2008 when she was 6 years old.
Okay. When is the last time you've used drugs, ma'am?
It's been over 2.5 years ago.
Okay.
Your
good.
Honor, there's some more straw out of the Jesus's manger because right here, this woman was arrested February the 4th of 2016
year?
For petty theft and drug abuse instrument possession. And here, I'll just add this.
Mm-hmm. Is that true, ma'am?
Yes, sir, I was arrested. I'm on probation.
So why'd you tell me that lie, ma'am?
Lie about being
clean for 2.5 years when you were just arrested for drugs and petty theft. You don't understand what I'm asking? Are
yes,
you
sir.
High now?
No, sir.
Okay,
no.
You don't seem to be able to understand
no.
that. Either that or you're trying to think about a lie.
No, I wasn't with drugs, Your Honor. I had it was a insulin needle on me. And it was my a friend of
You're
mine.
You're a dope fiend still. Go ahead, sir. That's a dope fiend story. I'm not going to even let you tell me
Your
that.
Your Honor,
you
get,
had insulin needles.
Tested.
Be quiet. Tell me about this child support, sir.
Your Honor.
Then I'll offer you some rehab inpatient. We'll help. We'll place you.
Your
and
Honor.
We'll see if you take it or you'll give us another story. Go ahead, sir. Tell me about the child support.
Not this court. But a family court where this case was originally instated granted me a monthly stipend of $50 a month, which that was mighty Christian of them to set that at that low ball figure of $50 a month. I think they probably did that under the impression that this woman was unemployed, you know. But over the course of the last 8 years, that amount has accrued to roughly $10,000. And $5,000 is the maximum that I can sue for. I am here today asking for that. I know that during my tenure as a correction officer in the county that this child support order was originally instated, I booked in many men. many, many, many men.
Yeah, she certainly can for go failure to, jail to comply. For this.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, and that's not what I'm here for. I don't want to see this woman go to jail. However, my daughter is a very special person. She's 14, she's going to be 15. And, you know, what the hell do I know about fixing somebody's hair, Your Honor? Look at my head. You know, it would be nice if maybe this woman could get some sort of, you know, court-ordered help. If maybe she can be a part of my child's life for the last couple years before she graduates high school and goes off to college. The window of time to do the right thing is small. And that to me, Your Honor, my child's happiness, because I know my daughter would like to know her mother. She hasn't seen her in over 5 years. I know my daughter would like to know her mother.
Why haven't you seen her in 5 years?
He hasn't allowed me to see her
what
in over 5 years.
What has he done to stop you?
He took me to court. I was having supervised visitation at my parents' house. Mm-hmm. Well, he took me to court and had that removed in 2011.
11.
He had that removed.
Why
so that
do you think
way,
that was?
I was on my way to prison at the time mm-hmm. because of my
All right,
abuse.
Ma'am. So he had
but
every
anyways,
reason to
he
keep
got,
you from
it
quiet.
Wasn't really hurting me.
I'm not going to listen to any more of this, ma'am. I don't blame him.
She's a heroin addict. I mean, this woman has been addicted to heroin for 8 years. She's been in and out of correctional facilities off and on.
Defendant Michelle Firm has a 14-year-old daughter with the plaintiff. But the plaintiff claims Michelle hasn't seen the child in 5 years because she's a heroin addict.
Sir, you have your child support printout. Ma'am, are you willing to go to rehab or be tested regularly? And if found dirty, go to rehab inpatient?
Your Honor.
Like that's I a said, yes or no. That's a very easy answer, unless you don't want to.
No, sir. I'm on probation.
Pardon me?
I do get tested regularly, once a week.
I'm talking about here.
I'm not able to do it here
because
I live in Ohio.
Somebody, we'll find the agency there.
I'm going through an agency right
will
now.
Will you allow us to participate? Because you might run game on that agency
sure.
there, but you ain't run a game on the judge.
Sure.
So,
Your Honor,
you've agreed to do so, and we'll see. All right? Good luck to you, sir. $5,000. Good luck to you and your daughter. Have a good day.
Listen, the ball's in her court. I have absolutely no intent on keeping my child from time with her mother. If she comes correct, that's all.
That's all I want is to be able to see my daughter.
Beautiful. Well, then it's all yours. You just stay sober and we'll be waiting for you.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay.